Welcome and thanks for joining me. Tonight, I'm going to go through the cleaning process of all the watch parts for my watch before I can put the watch back together. Cleaning is a pretty important process, and I also want to touch on shockproof setting springs. So if you didn't know, I was enrolled into the British Horological Watchmaking course, and it was a distance watchmaking course. It's really full on. They encourage you to have an apprenticeship with a watchmaker. It takes 2 years to complete minimum. So where most of my teaching reference comes from is from that information. Also, just a disclaimer, I haven't completed the course. It's quite extensive and it's more for repair, which I don't want to go down that path. I don't see a benefit right now for completing that. So I'm going to start by removing the end cap jewels. So the jewel is kept by this really thin brass spring. And there's a couple of manufacturers. There's Inca Block and Kif. And Kif have like a whole range of different arrangements of springs. And I thought Inca Block only had one. But apparently this style that I have on my watch is also Inca Block. It's a more newer one. Apparently I didn't know. It's called Novo Dyak. It looks pretty similar to a Kif reference one spring. But I had no idea that this was Inca Block until just a few moments ago, until I was looking it up. So if you've come across this one or the Kif, I'm going to show you how to make a quick little tool to remove these springs with ease. And all you need is a bit of pegwood and a knife. If you didn't know, I hope that helps. If you did know, well, you can critique it. And if you have any other methods for removing these springs, let me know. So that's the chemical cleaning done. I want to keep going, and I can keep going, but it's going to wreck me for days. So I just want to be consistent, documenting every day, and